Previously, we have a laptop with no HDMI output. On closer inspection, I found that the HDMI port is broken. In this video, I will try to fix it. Welcome to Amateur Hardware Repair. In this channel, I fix the electronics as an amateur and rank the difficulties so that you don't have to go through the same pain as I do. Let's get started. The HDMI port is entangled together with the Wi-Fi module and the VGA display port. The Wi-Fi module is relatively easy to be removed, but it is quite tricky to remove the rest of the modules. I couldn't figure out how to remove the display module, even after removing all the screws I could find on the motherboard. Something is holding it tight. Usually, it means there are still hidden screws somewhere. After looking around, these two pieces of metal look suspicious. Maybe they are holding it tight. Bingo! Indeed, they are. Finally, I can remove the display module. But these cables are getting in my way, so I have to remove them first. Ah, now what? There's another cable underneath the display module? Ah, there's no choice. I have to remove it first. But how do I get into this narrow space? In situations like this, tweezers are your best friends. Finally, the display module is out. It's time to do HDMI replacement. First, we need to desolder the broken HDMI port. With a little bit of hot air, bam, the HDMI port is gone. It's so beautiful. Let's clean it before putting a new HDMI port back. To do that, we need flux. According to Google, it removes oxidation and promotes wetting. Things always go smoother when it's wet enough. We also need to apply some
Vomit solder,
according to my favorite YouTuber. Next, we also need a copper wick to remove the old solder on the surface. Finally, we can put a replacement HDMI port back and blow some hot air. Let's check if all connections are solid. This pin is loose. Okay, I need to use a soldering iron to connect them one by one. Now, it looks much better. Let's double check. Everything is solid this time. Let's secure the port. Amazing! Finally, we can clean up and put everything back together. Let's check if everything is working or not. Be careful not to break the HDMI port again. Yes, that's it. The HDMI port is fixed. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Oh, how difficult was the HDMI replacement, you ask? I would say it's definitely a 4.5 out of 5 difficult repair. Why? Let me show you the disaster behind the scene. On day 1, I got a hot air station and a broken circuit board ready to get some hands-on experience. It's always important to practice before you try any new repair you haven't done before. This circuit board is perfect for practicing because it has at least 3 HDMI ports. I'm setting up my PCB holders here so that I can hold up the board when blowing hot air. It also ensures there's enough clearance below the board so that the HDMI port can fall down easily. Let's begin the fun, blowing hot air. It has been 1 minute. The HDMI port is still strongly attached to the board. Maybe I don't have enough support. That's why the HDMI port is not coming off. Let's add one more holder. Why is it not coming off? It's been 2 minutes and it's still not falling off? Something isn't right. HDMI replacement is supposed to be easy. To confirm how easy it is supposed to be, I go to the best educational website and look for some examples.
I'm going to push up on the port a little bit just to let it fall all the way down. There we go.
There's low melt solder, low melt solder, low melt solder.
Then I spend the rest of the day watching HDMI replacement. They all look easy. On day 2, I prepare a soldering iron, bought some
low melt solder
and flux. Then I apply flux and low melt solder to existing solder joints to see if they can make things easier. It's time to try again. Let's blow some hot air. Same as before, the solder joints are not melting at all. Maybe there's not enough
low melt solder.
I think we need to add a bit more. For your information, my soldering iron is set to 300 degrees Celsius right now. But still, I'm having a difficult time melting the solder joints. For the hot air station, it is set to 250 degrees Celsius. It seems using both the hot air gun and the soldering iron simultaneously makes things a bit easier, which implies that my hot air temperature is not high enough. So I set them to a higher temperature, from 250 to 390 degrees Celsius for the hot air. For the soldering iron, from 300 to 350 degrees Celsius. Let's try again with the new temperature setting. Alright, the soldering successful. There's no damage on the HDMI port, and also there's no damage to the motherboard. Everything looks good. Next, I would like to check if applying only the flux would make things easier. It takes almost the same time as before to desolder the HDMI port. I guess flux doesn't help much. Okay, setting the correct temperature seems to be the key to a successful desoldering. The reason why I was reluctant to set a high temperature is due to thermal expansion. I find expanding motherboard extremely terrifying. Can you see it? Let's rewind and watch again. That's why I always set the temperature as low as possible. Oh no, desoldering is just the first step. I still need to clean the surface and resolder a new one back. Let's also practice it on the same board. Using a copper wick is not as easy as I imagined either. Now, I need to remove the old solder from the anchor point so that I can plug a new HDMI port in later. The old solder inside the anchor points are too difficult to be removed. After 10 minutes of trying, I gave up. I guess I will just simply melt the solder with my lovely hot air when I put a new HDMI port back. Okay, the new port is attached, but how about the contact pads? Oh no, it's a mess. I hope I can simply fix it with a soldering iron. Is it done? Let's have a look. Oh no, it seems none of the contact pad is properly soldered. I hope adding a bit more solder will fix it. Obviously, some of them become solid now. But most of them are still loose. Adding even more solder will do it, I guess. I hate to say it, but it seems I have made things even worse with more solder. Ah, all the pins are shorted together. I have to remove it before things explode. Removing solder blobs is also difficult as hell. What's wrong? Is it because I'm using the wrong iron tip? Maybe I should use a thinner one and give it a try. Instead of soldering a few pins at once and short everything together, maybe I should do it one by one. I don't think it's working here. I give up. Let's call it a day. The board I was practicing on yesterday was all messed up, so I got myself another one to have a fresh start. This time, I would like to know if low melt solder makes a difference. Let's start without it. Without low melt solder, it takes around 1 minute. Now, let's see what happens if we add low melt solder. forty-five seconds only, so it does help. Desoldering successful. Let's practice resoldering now. Wait, that's it? I was struggling yesterday. Today, everything seems so easy. All the solder joints are solid. Okay, I will do it one more time to make sure it's not a fluke. This time, the pads are a bit misaligned. Let's adjust it a little bit. Everything is perfect now. I think it's time to do it for real. I tried to find a suitable replacement, but it seems it's difficult to find one with the exact anchor point spacing. So I searched online and ordered a bunch of them, hoping that one of them will be a perfect fit. A week later, my order finally arrived. I quickly unpacked all of them to see if I can hit the jackpot. Sadly, it seems none of them fits. So I have no choice but to brute force it, so that I can put it back to the display module. Oh my god, it's taking forever.
20 minutes later.
I think it can finally fit. What a mess we have made here. This is the new one, and this is the old one. It's time to plug it back and resolder it. Everything looks good so far, until I try to close the laptop case. We have a problem here. I just can't seem to be able to close the laptop case. Ah, snap! The replacement has a wrong orientation. I'm too exhausted after all the grinding and thinking. Let's continue tomorrow. I can't find any HDMI port having the same orientation and the same anchor point spacing as the original HDMI port. The only replacement with the same orientation is the one for PS4. But the anchor point spacing is definitely different from the one for my laptop. I don't think I want to do another grinding. So I look at my broken HDMI port and the fallen pins to see what can I do with them. Then I came up with this idea. Maybe I can put the fallen pins back. But I have in total 4 missing pins in the broken HDMI port. Even after putting the 2 pins back, there are still 2 missing pins. So I started messing around to see if I can transfer the pins from the new HDMI port to the broken one. The answer is yes, I can simply push the pins out. Then I transfer the pins to the broken HDMI port. However, the new pins are larger than the original one, so it doesn't quite fit and I have a hard time inserting the pins. With some trial and error and a bit of adjustment, I somehow made it into an acceptable state. You can see that the newly inserted pins are slightly shorter than the other pins. But I guess it's still long enough to make contact with the HDMI cable. After this, I was super exhausted and wanted to get the job done and go home already. I forgot to hit the record button and the rest of the footage for soldering and reassembling are all missing. But you get the idea. After all the hard work, I have a barely functioning HDMI port, and the pins could easily fall out again if I plug the HDMI cable too hard. In summary, if it is your first time replacing a HDMI port, I would say it's actually a 4.5 out of 5 difficult repair. With some practice and experience, I feel like the difficulty could be reduced to 2 out of 5. Finally, let's answer the question, should you replace a HDMI port yourself? The answer depends on the following points. Do you have a good hot air station and soldering iron? To conduct a successful replacement, you need to make sure the temperature is hot enough to melt the solder, but not too hot that it damages the board. Also, you need to make sure that you can find the right replacement. For common devices such as PS4 and PS5, there should be no problem. But for laptops, you might have a hard time finding the suitable replacement, which means that if you don't have the equipment and time, HDMI replacement might not be for you. Nevertheless, if you are a repair enthusiast, HDMI replacement is definitely something fun to try. My first attempt didn't go too well, but I learned a lot and had a lot of fun. This is Amateur Hardware Repair. Have fun repairing and see you next time.